Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to St John's Parish Church, Jersey, for our Advent service of Remembrance this evening. My name's Beverley Sproats and I'm the rector. The service is being live streamed to Facebook as well, so welcome to everyone joining us online and to those watching later wherever you are. Thanks for tuning in and please say hello in the comments. A really warm welcome to you if you're joining us for the first time in person or online today. Thank you for bearing with us as we manage social distancing, having to have a limit on numbers and book, and wearing masks and hygiene and so on. In this service, we'll remember before God loved ones who have died, both in the recent and distant past, and there'll be the opportunity to light a candle in their memory as we pray for strength to face the future. All the words for the service and hymns are on the screen, and you're invited to join in as much as you like, and the sentences in bold yellow type are the ones we're invited to read out together. Let's pray as we begin. Father God, thank you that despite restrictions, that we are able to gather together to worship you and to remember before you our loved ones who have died. In Jesus' name, amen. In the name of Christ, who died and was raised by the glory of the Father, we welcome you. God's grace, mercy, and peace be with you.
And also with you.
We meet this day to renew our trust and confidence in Christ, and to give thanks to God for those who have gone from our sight, but whose memory we hold dear. For all your servants departed this life, we thank you, good Lord. For the memory of their words and deeds,
we thank you, good Lord.
For the sure and certain hope of reunion with them hereafter,
we thank you, good Lord.
For the joy that is now theirs,
we thank you, good Lord.
And for our communion with them in your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord,
we thank you, good Lord.
Unfortunately, we're still not allowed to sing, but we can hum along, so with our hymns this afternoon, we're going to join in with by humming along. Please stand as we hum along to our first hymn, Dear Lord and Father of Mankind.
Thank you.
are you, Lord our God, lover of all you have made. You uphold us in life and sustain us in death. To you be glory and praise forever. As you give light to those in darkness who walk in the shadow of death, so remember in your kingdom your faithful servants, that death may be for them the gate to life and unending fellowship with you. May they rest in your presence until the day of resurrection, when all things in heaven and earth are renewed in Christ, and your people live and reign with you in one perfect union of love, now and forever. Amen. And we remain seated for our first Bible reading.
The first reading is taken from Lamentations chapter 3, verses 21 to 26 and 31 to 33. Yet this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for his compassion never fails. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. I say to myself, the Lord is my portion, therefore I will wait for him. The Lord is good to those who hope is in him, to the one who seeks him. It is good to wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord. For no one is cast off by the Lord forever. Though he brings grief, he will show compassion. So great is his unfailing love. For he does not willingly bring affliction or grief to anyone. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And we remain seated for our second Bible reading.
The second reading is taken from Romans chapter 8, verses 31 to 39. More than conquerors. What then shall we in response to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all. How will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? Is it God who justifies? Who then is the one who condemns? No one. Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God and is also interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, may my words and all our thoughts be acceptable to you, our strength in times of difficulty and sadness, and our Redeemer. Amen. Whenever I visit a family to prepare for a funeral of their loved one, It's always an honour to listen to stories of their loved ones and memories that they have from times together. I'm always interested to hear how a couple met or what hobbies they had. And families often share funny memories at funerals, like the practical jokes and the pranks that their loved ones played on family and friends. It's good to remember, especially happy times, isn't it? The word remember crops up in all sorts of song lyrics, in different songs sung by singers as diverse as Gloria Estefan, Lou Reed, Dolly Parton and Nat King Cole, to name a few. Johnny Cash sang a song called I Forgot to Remember to Forget. The first Bible reading we heard speaks of remembrance, and the Jews were often encouraged, especially during difficult periods, to remember what God had done for them in the past. In particular, they were often told to think back on how God had freed them from slavery under the Egyptians and brought them through the wilderness to the promised land. The book of Lamentations, from which the first reading was taken, was written about the 6th century BC, shortly after the city of Jerusalem had been destroyed and the Jews had been taken into exile in Babylon. It was a dreadful time which the Jews had really brought upon themselves by turning away from God. And the book, as suggested in the title, laments what has happened, recognises the sin that has caused it, and appeals to God for forgiveness and restoration. In the passage from Lamentations, the writer calls to mind the Lord's great love, which sustains his people, and his faithfulness. And it's this passage that the hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness, which we're going to sing later, is based upon. The writer says, it's good to wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord, for no one is cast off by the Lord forever. Though he brings grief, he will show compassion. So great is his unfailing love. We come here today in remembrance of loved ones who have died. And no doubt because of their death, we've had times of despair, like the Jews were experiencing when the Book of Lamentations was written. Its writer affirms that because he remembers God's past goodness, he has hope for the future and is able to wait for God to save him from the present despair. And so his words encourage us to remember with gladness the good times spent with our loved ones and to wait with trust for the better times that our faithful God will bring us. In difficult times in my life, such as now during the coronavirus pandemic that we're all trying to cope with, I try to remember God's faithfulness in previous times, and I find that doing that gives me hope that things will get better and helps me through those hard times. When the writer of Lamentations wrote of a better future and the salvation of the Lord, he was thinking of the Jews' salvation from their enemies, a return from exile to their own country, and the restoration of Jerusalem, all of which did occur. In our second reading that we heard from Paul's letter to the Romans, he reassures us that as we place our hope in God, nothing can come between us and God's love. Paul has been through many difficult times, yet is able to say, if God is for us, who can be against us? Paul knows that the God who did not spare his only son, Jesus, but gave him for us all to be forgiven from sin and live in relationship with him, will give us everything we need. The Jews had great hope in God's faithfulness, and Paul knew that because of God's great love and faithfulness, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. Paul's words reassure us that nothing can separate us from the love of God. So as we remember our loved ones, let us, in the sadness of their loss, be thankful for the happy memories we have of them, and let us reflect upon and remember with gratitude and hope God's gracious gift of new life through faith in his Son, Jesus. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you that you love us and are always with us in times of sadness. Teach us to look beyond the apparent finality of death to the promise of new life possible through the death and resurrection of your Son, Jesus. May your Holy Spirit convince us of the truth of this, stir our hearts, and help us to live a life that reflects the reassurance, hope, and confidence we have in Jesus. For we pray in his name. Amen. And now we're going to sing of God's faithfulness for our next hymn that we're going to hum along to, Great is Thy Faithfulness. Please stand. but and that's my fault for not giving the right number of verses to Paul out all of this. That's a good hymn to sing. Or hum, indeed.
Now let us pray. Almighty God, as you bring us face to face with our mortality, we thank you for making each of us in your image and giving us gifts in body, mind and spirit. We thank you now as we remember before you those whom we love but see no more. Grant us grace, O Lord, to entrust them to your never-failing love and to find in you the strength to meet the days to come, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The names of those to be remembered will now be read out.
Peggy Britton,
Rudolph Robert Crevin,
Peter Banner,
Gwendolyn Mary Delahaye, Natan,
Brian Illingworth,
Stephen Jean,
Bernard Jean,
Beryl Ada LeGros, Nay Delahaye,
Jean Muriel Tyrrell, nee Vibert.
Francis Allen Green.
Michael Gort.
Margaret Marie Le Saint, nee Cartel.
Garnet Emile Delahaye.
Alan Brickley.
Erica Blondell. Nay Doring.
Nicholas Allen Green.
Kathleen Amy LeCornu. Nay Turns.
Terry Roach.
Mick Mousard.
Russell Marmorod.
David Fry.
Tracy Jane Goodchild. Nay Foss.
Eva Beryl Bale, nay Kelland.
Irene May Boutier, nay Rondell.
Lawrence Edward Bale.
Terence Rory Connolly.
George Francis Boutier.
John Alphus LeCornu.
Stephen Robert Boutier.
Thank you. And now I invite you to light a candle in memory of your loved one. Paul Matthams is going to play a musical reflection for us, and everyone's welcome to come forward and light a candle as we remember our loved ones before God. If I can encourage you to leave lots of space between household groups, I've come up the south aisle, and if you can, come back down the north aisle, so we have a bit of a one-way system. There are people at the table who will light the tea light for you, and then you can place it on a plate so that we're not handing the tapers back and forth. Once everyone's returned to their seats, then we'll have a minute's silent remembrance. We'll stand for that. So please can I invite you to light the candle.
Thank you.
stand as we have a minute's silent remembrance. Please be seated as we pray. Help us, Lord, to receive and understand your gospel so that we may find light in our darkness, faith in our doubts, and comfort for one another in your saving truth. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Fill the emptiness of our hearts with the presence of your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Increase our faith and strengthen our hope. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray for all who mourn, that they too may be comforted in their loss. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Once again, my name is Beverley Sproats, and it's lovely to have you with us at St John's Parish Church, both in person and on Facebook live stream for our Advent service of remembrance. Welcome to everyone here in person and those joining us online. I'll just share with you a few notices. The Lady Chapel, which is come in the door on the right, that part of church, will be open on Wednesday for private prayer from 9 a.m. until 3 p.m. And due to a change in government guidelines, we're now limited to 20 people plus 5 helping at a service. So for our 8 o'clock service of communion, you do not need to book, but you do need to book for the 9:30 service. And there's a link to Eventbrite on Facebook, or if you know someone who has trouble accessing the internet, do let us know. Our services next Sunday, the 6th of December, are 8 a.m. traditional Holy Communion and 9:30 contemporary Holy Communion. You're invited to our Christmas services. Due to limited numbers, some of our Christmas services will be in person in church with booking required, and some will be online only. And all services will be on Facebook and later on YouTube. The candlelit carol service will be online at 6 p.m. on Sunday the 13th of December on Facebook and YouTube, and then available to watch afterwards. The Christingle service will be online on Christmas Eve, so you can make a Christingle at home and then watch the Christingle service. Midnight Holy Communion at 11:30 on Christmas Eve will be in church in person with booking required, and also on Facebook Live. And Christmas Day celebration will be at 10:30 and will be in person in church and on Facebook Live, and there will not be booking required for that. At the end of the service, there'll be a retiring collection for the ministry and mission of St John's Parish Church. There's a basket and a card reader available on the table on the way out. And also, if you're joining us online, you can go to tinyl.com/St John's Church JE to go to our online giving page. Now we're going to hum along to our final hymn, Amazing Grace. Please stand as we hum along to Amazing Grace. Strengthen you in his service. The joy of the Lord Jesus fill your hearts, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.